Hi, I'm Matt Merrill, and you're watching Active Riverside. Today we're going to learn about tumbling here at the Orange Terrace Community Center. And to tell me about the history and what's happening present day is Cindy Angevine. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Matt.
So yeah. tell me a little bit about what you do here with tumbling and where tumbling came from.
Well, to be honest, tumbling came from the ancient Greeks. Back in Greece, they used to have competitions back and forth, and that's where we got our Olympics from. Today, tumbling has progressed so much, basically because of all the equipment that is offered to our athletes now. What we can see our athletes do is just incredible, because we have use of springs, air floors, mats, and so it's become a much safer and a very healthy sport.
Okay, so since it's safe, I want to get tumbling right away. What do I need to do in order to get tumbling right now?
The very first thing you need to do is you need to stretch.
Okay.
Can't stretch cold muscles, so you need to do a warm-up.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to get you warmed up. We're going to bring a class in here. We've got a class that has between beginning, intermediate, and advanced gymnasts, so you're going to get to see all different levels, and we'll see how you fit in.
I don't think I'm going to fit in very well, but we'll see.
Sure.
All right, let's get to the warm-up.
Okay, so Matt, what we're going to teach you is a basic forward roll.
Okay.
We're going to use the incline because that's going to help you. It's going to give you just a little bit more momentum to help you with the stand part.
Okay.
Go ahead and have it.
Sit down or kneel down?
Go ahead and stand right up there.
Okay.
You can stand up right on the top.
Stand up on the, okay,
yep.
Both feet.
And put your feet together. Good. You're going to reach your hands up to the sky. Good. Keep your arms right next to your ears, because in gymnastics, it's all about straight lines. We always want to protect the head and the neck.
Okay.
So when you bring your hands down, keep them by your ears as you bring your hands down to the mat. Perfect. There you go. Now you're going to tuck your chin into your chest, bend your elbows, and set the back part of your head on the mat. Okay? Good. Good. Nice.
Now,
okay, so that's the front part of the roll. Now the second part is right here, where you're going to reach forward, go ahead and grab my hands, and stand up. Yes.
Okay.
So you want to reach into that direction as you stand up to keep the momentum going forward.
Got it.
Okay? Go ahead and try it. The next one is the backward roll. Okay? So go ahead and have a seat right here. Feet together. Put your hands right here, like you're holding two pizzas. Elbows forward. Good. Now, I'm going to push on your hands. I want you to push your hands up to the sky. Yes. As fast as you can. Good. Again. Nice. Okay. As soon as your hands touch the mat, that is what you're going to do. And at the same time, you're going to take your knees back with your chest. So as your shoulders come back to the mat, your knees are going to come with you, and you're going to reach your toes to the red mat. That's when you're going to push. Okay? You reach your toes to the blue mat behind you.
Okay.
Go. I'll help you. Yes, you got it. You got it. Do it again. You don't need my help.
It's just that not seeing what's going on behind you is kind of...
Exactly. You have to trust yourself.
It's a mental thing, yeah.
Yes. Well,
I'm not quite at that spot yet.
Okay, take those knees with you and go. Nice. Now, when you stand up, remember we always want to protect the head and the neck.
Okay.
So when you stand up with your arms right by your ears.
Okay.
Try again. What you're going to try to do is you want to learn to transfer your weight hand, feet, feet over there. Now, you always want your hands to face in the same direction. Whatever leg is forward is the closest to the mat right there, and your hands point that way as well.
Okay.
So you're going to set your hands down here, jump your legs over, and come up. And
so I'm going to put my hands on the,
exactly,
on the step.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And it's just going to kind of be a guide for you, okay?
Okay?
Each time, I want you to get your legs a little bit higher, a little bit higher, and a little bit higher. So when it ends, So when it ends, you're doing this up high. Okay, good. Squeeze your ears with your arms. Nice. And go. There you go. Squeeze your ears and bring it on back. Nice. Good. What you're going to do now is up at the top, you're going to bring your feet together and then snap them down. Okay. So scoot that way just a little bit for me. So you're going to do the same thing that you did before, but notice how at the top, my feet come together and then snap down. Okay. So that's what you're going to do is you're going to stop. Now I'll spot you on the first few to help you get those feet together and then as you come down. Okay.
Which way do you want? Let's see. If I go this way.
Which cartwheel felt the best to you?
This one.
That one? Okay. So let's do this one.
All right. Okay, now I gotta snap my feet.
Yeah, get those feet together up top. Really reach those toes to the sky. There, not bad.
All right.
Do it again. You're gonna start with that right foot forward. And you want to think about keeping those arms next to your head. You never want to come down with your hands first. You want to make sure you come down with those arms right by your ears. Now you want to think of it like a teeter-totter. When a teeter-totter goes, it doesn't do this. A teeter-totter does this, right?
Yeah.
Played on a teeter-totter before?
Yep.
Okay, so your hands are here and it's one seat of the teeter-totter. Your feet are the other seat of the teeter-totter. You don't want your hands to come down first and then your feet to come up. You want it to happen simultaneously. So, as I bring my hands down, my feet are coming up, and then I bring it back down. And my arms stay by my ears as I come down and up. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's try it.
Cool. All right.
One foot forward.
I need to, what I just need to do is not throw my legs over, because I would have just landed on my back on doing that.
Right.
So I just need to be a little bit more careful when I put my...
And squeeze when you get up to the top, squeeze those legs together.
Okay.
Good. And now come back down. And arms up. Nice. Look at you. Go again.
I'd like to thank Cindy for being such a gracious host and teaching me a little bit about tumbling today. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, Matt, thank you so much for coming. And I just hope that everybody realizes that here at Orange Terrace Community Center, there's several classes that we offer for health and fitness, and it's so important for everybody.
Well, how about one more tumble for the road, and let's just show everybody what I learned
Sounds
today.
Great.
All right.
Sounds great. Let's see it.
Thanks for joining me. Till next time, stay active, Riverside.